Hello, my dear students. Welcome to another class on theatre studies. So these days we are learning about Elizabethan theatre, Elizabethan drama. So we already covered a few portions regarding British drama. We learned about the evolution of drama in England, how it evolved out of religious practices related to church. We learned that. After that, we learned about the development of proper drama. We learned about the first English comedy and tragedy. After that, we dealt with university wits and William Shakespeare, the most important dramatist of all time. And after discussing Shakespeare's writing career and his history plays, comedy plays, romances and tragedies, in this class, I would like to discuss the structure of Elizabethan theatre. So, when we learned about Greek theatre, you might remember that we learned in quite a few detail about the structure of Greek theatre, how the stage was arranged, where the audience sat, and where the chorus was. So, we learned about the structure. Likewise, in Elizabethan theatre also, it is extremely important to understand the structure and various elements of Elizabethan theatre. So this is an example of Elizabethan theatre. This is a model. So this particular theatre design, it was inspired from bear baiting or cock fighting arenas. And also inn yards where troops of travelling players had been performing for some time. So these bear baiting and cock fighting, these were two pastimes for English population during that time. അവരുടെ ഒരു ഇഷ്ട വിനോദമായിരുന്നു ബേ ബേറ്റിംഗ്. രണ്ട് വിനോദങ്ങളായിരുന്നു ബേ ബേറ്റിംഗ് ആൻഡ് കോക്ക് ഫൈറ്റിംഗ്. കോക്ക് ഫൈറ്റിംഗ് ഇസ് ആക്ച്വലി ക്വൈറ്റ് പോപ്പുലർ ഇൻ സം പാർട്സ് ഓഫ് ഇന്ത്യ ടു ദർ വിൽ ബി ടു ഫൈറ്റിംഗ് കോക്സ് റൂസ്റ്റേഴ്സ് റെഡി ടു ഫൈറ്റ് വിത്ത് ഈച്ച് അതർ ആൻഡ് ബെറ്റ്സ് ആർ പ്ലേസ്ഡ് ഓൺ ദെം. റിഗാർഡിംഗ് ദാറ്റ് കോഴിപ്പോര് എന്ന് പറഞ്ഞ് ഇന്ത്യയുടെ പല ഭാഗത്തായിട്ട് നമ്മൾ സൗത്ത് ഇന്ത്യയിലൊക്കെ നടന്നു വരുന്നൊരു സംഭവമാണ്. ആൻഡ് ബേ ബേറ്റിംഗ് ഇൻവോൾവ്സ് എ ബെയർ. സോ ദീസ് വർ ഇമ്പോർട്ടൻ്റ് പാസ് ടൈംസ് ഡ്യൂറിങ് എലിസബത്തൻ പീരിയഡ്. ആൻഡ് ദി അരീനാസ് ഇൻ വിച്ച് ദീസ് പാസ് ടൈംസ് വർ പെർഫോംഡ് ഓർ ഇറ്റ് ടുക്ക് പ്ലേസ്, ദീസ് അരീനാസ് ആക്ച്വലി ഇൻസ്പയർഡ് ദ സ്ട്രക്ചർ ഓഫ് എലിസബത്തൻ തിയേറ്റർ. ഓൾസോ ഡ്യൂറിങ് ദിസ് ടൈം ദർ വർ ട്രൂപ്സ് ഓഫ് ട്രാവലിംഗ് പ്ലേയേഴ്സ്, യാത്ര ചെയ്ത് നാടകം അവതരിപ്പിക്കുന്ന ട്രൂപ്സ് ഉണ്ടായിരുന്നു. ദേ യൂസ് ടു സ്റ്റേജ് ദ പ്ലേസ് ഇൻ യാർഡ്സ്. സോ ദിസ് പെർട്ടിക്കുലർ സ്ട്രക്ചർ ഇറ്റ് വാസ് ഇൻസ്പയർഡ് ബൈ ബേ ബേറ്റിംഗ് ഓർ കോക്ക് ഫൈറ്റിംഗ് അരീനാസ് ആൻഡ് ഓൾസോ ഇൻ യാർഡ്സ് വേർ ദീസ് ട്രൂപ്സ് പെർഫോം ദർ പ്ലേസ്. സോ റിഗാർഡിംഗ് ദ ഷേപ്പ്, ഇറ്റ് വാസ് ഈദർ ഹെക്ടഗണൽ ഓർ hexagonal or octagonal outside. It could even be round, but hexagonal shape and octagonal shape were the most important, the most common shapes in which we found Elizabethan theatre. And it was always round with it. Agatha round porathu hexagon allengil octagon shape ilum aayirunnu. And it had a roof. It had a thatched roof covering the structure. And it also had an open courtyard in the center. So it had a thatched roof covering, if you can see it here, and an open courtyard in the center. Now regarding seating arrangements, let's look at this picture once again. This is a model of Globe Theater for tourists. When they visit this particular place, they can just take a look at the model of Globe Theatre. So regarding seating arrangements, in those days people from all social classes, upper class, middle class and lower class, they used to come to the theatres. These theatres were public theatres, they were open to all classes. But the lower class, they rarely sat in the theatre. They always, most often they stood in the pit near the stage. So this particular area is the pit. So they usually stood in this pit. So they were also always called groundlings because they stood on the ground. or they were also called understanding men because they were always standing underneath, you know, the stage, near the stage, but a little under. So lower class men, they rarely sat, they stood in this pit. So they were called groundlings or understanding men. And regarding the stage was a raised platform. But unlike the kind of stages we have in this time, ippozhthe stage pole alla, a part of the stage used to jut out into the yard or pit. ഈ പിറ്റിലേക്ക് ഉന്തി നിൽക്കുന്ന ഒരു ഫ്രണ്ട് പോർഷൻ സ്റ്റേജിന് ഉണ്ടാവാറുണ്ട്. സോ ഹിയർ ഇൻ ദിസ് വിസിനിറ്റി ദർ വിൽ ബി പീപ്പിൾ ഹു വിൽ സ്റ്റാൻഡ് ഹിയർ നിയർ ദിസ് പാർട്ട്. ഇവിടെ താഴേക്ക് നിൽക്കും. ദ യൂഷ്വലി ഗെറ്റ് ദ ചീപ്പസ്റ്റ് ടിക്കറ്റ്സ് ടു ദ തിയേറ്റർ. സോ ദ നെവർ സാറ്റ് ഡ്യൂറിംഗ് ദ പെർഫോമൻസ്. ദ സ്റ്റുഡ് ത്രൂ ഔട്ട് ദ പെർഫോമൻസ്. And regarding higher class people, they could afford better seating. They were seated in these galleries. If you can see, there were three rows of galleries in this particular theater structure. So there were three rows, the first row, second row and third row. So people who could afford to buy better seating, they used to sit in this three galleries, three sets of seating along the sides of the theater. And the most expensive seat in the theater, it was in the gallery directly above the stage. So let's see this. So this is the stage, and if you can see, there is a little space here. This particular space is called the Lord's room. Lord's room was the most expensive seat on the house, in the house. So it was also the most honorable seat. So people who sat there, they were not able to see the performance as well. But sitting there was actually a part of showing off their wealth to the people, so that everyone who was in the theater could see them and grasp just how wealthy they are. So that was the intention of these wealthy people who bought tickets to Lord's room. So Lord's room ആണ് ഏറ്റവും എക്സ്പെൻസീവ് ആയിട്ടുള്ള റൂം. അപ്പൊ ഇത് ഇവിടെ നിന്നാ ശരിക്ക് കാണാനൊന്നും പറ്റില്ലെങ്കിലും അവരുടെ വെൽത്ത് ഒക്കെ ഷോ ഓഫ് ചെയ്യാൻ വേണ്ടിയിട്ടാണ് അവരത് ചെയ്തിരുന്നത്. ആൻഡ് ദെൻ ദർ വർ അതർ ലെസ്സർ എക്സ്പെൻസീവ് സീറ്റ്സ്. അത് സെക്കൻഡ് മോസ്റ്റ് എക്സ്പെൻസീവ് സീറ്റ്സ് വെ ദർ വർ ദീസ് അഡീഷണൽ ബാൽക്കണീസ് ഓൺ ദ സൈഡ്സ് ഓഫ് ലോർഡ്സ് റൂം. Like this, if you can see these chambers on the left and right of Lord's room, you can actually see this part. The seats are much more comfortable than these three sets of galleries. So these rooms were called gentlemen's rooms. These are gentlemen's room on the left and right of Lord's room. And this was the second most expensive seat in the theater. So, and then you can see the stage wall structure. In the stage there will be two doors leading inwards. It will lead to certain rooms where the costume change and all take place. That particular place was called the tiring house. So the musicians and the costume change, it all took place in the tiring house. So tiring house is just a room behind the stage. There are two doors on the left and right of the stage that leads into the tiring house. The costume change, the music for the play, it all takes place in the tiring house. And another structure is the hut. Hut is above the tiring house. So tiring house in the മുകളിലായിട്ട് ചെറിയൊരു കൂര പോലെ ഒരു റൂഫ് ഉണ്ടാവും. So this particular roofed building was called the hut. Again, it was a small house like structure. It was complete with a roof. So this is all about the seating arrangements of Elizabethan theatre. Now let's look at the Elizabethan stage. Stage was the most important part or the centerpiece of Elizabethan theatre. Stage was mainly built with wood. It was a wooden structure and it was really large and open. It was an open arena. Sometimes it was as large as 40 square feet. So it's quite a large stage. If you can see this, it's quite a large stage. And As I mentioned earlier, the front part of the stage will jut out into the pit. സ്റ്റേജിൻ്റെ ഒരു ചെറിയ ഭാഗം മുന്നോട്ടിങ്ങനെ ഉന്തി നിൽക്കും പിറ്റിലേക്ക്. ദിസ് പെർട്ടിക്കുലർ പാർട്ട് വാസ് കോൾഡ് ഏപ്രൺ സ്റ്റേജ്. ഇറ്റ് ഇസ് കോൾഡ് ഏപ്രൺ സ്റ്റേജ്. സോ യൂഷ്വലി ഇൻ ദി ഏപ്രൺ സ്റ്റേജ് ദേ യൂസ് ടു ഫീച്ചർ ഔട്ട്ഡോർ സീൻസ് ഇൻ ഡ്രാമ ലൈക്ക് ബാറ്റിൽ ഫീൽഡ്, പബ്ലിക് സ്ട്രീറ്റ്സ് എക്സെട്ര. സോ ഓൾ ദീസ് ബാറ്റിൽസ് ആൻഡ് സ്ട്രീറ്റ്സ് എക്സെട്ര ദാറ്റ് വാസ് പോർട്രേഡ് ഇൻ ദിസ് പെർട്ടിക്കുലർ റീജിയൻ. ഇറ്റ് വാസ് യൂഷ്വലി റെക്ടാംഗുലർ ഇൻ ഷേപ്പ്, ഓൾദോ ഇറ്റ് ഇസ് പോർട്രേഡ് ആസ് ട്രയാംഗിൾ ഹിയർ, ഇറ്റ് വാസ് യൂഷ്വലി റെക്ടാംഗുലർ ഇൻ ഷേപ്പ്. സോ ദാറ്റ് ഇസ് കോൾഡ് ഏപ്രൺ സ്റ്റേജ്, ദ പാർട്ട് വിച്ച് ജട്സ് ഔട്ട് ഇൻ ടു ദ പിറ്റ്. ആൻഡ് അനദർ ഇമ്പോർട്ടൻറ്റ് ഫീച്ചർ ഇസ് on this apron stage there were trap doors were a common feature in the apron stage. So you know that in Elizabethan drama, especially in tragedies, there were supernatural elements like ghosts and spirits. So these ghosts, witches, spirits, etc., they made their entries and exits through this trap door on the apron stage. ഏപ്രൺ സ്റ്റേജിൽ ഉണ്ടായിരുന്ന ചെറിയൊരു ട്രാപ്പ് ഡോർ വഴി പ്രേതങ്ങൾ അങ്ങനെയുള്ള ക്യാരക്ടേഴ്സൊക്കെ എൻട്രിയും എക്സിറ്റും ചെയ്യുന്നുണ്ടായിരുന്നു. സോ ദാറ്റ് ഇസ് അനദർ കോമൺ ഫീച്ചർ ഓഫ് എലിസബത്തൻ സ്റ്റേജ്. ആൻഡ് നൗ ലെറ്റ്സ് ഗോ ടു ദ റിയർ ഓഫ് ദ സ്റ്റേജ്. ദിസ് പെർട്ടിക്കുലർ പ്ലാറ്റ്ഫോം, ഇറ്റ്സ് കോൾഡ് ദ പ്ലാറ്റ്ഫോം സ്റ്റേജ്. ബിഹൈൻഡ് ദി ഏപ്രൺ സ്റ്റേജ് ഇസ് ദ പ്ലാറ്റ്ഫോം സ്റ്റേജ്. ദർ വർ ടു ജൈജാന്റിക് പില്ലേഴ്സ് on the platform stage. These pillars supported the hut, this particular roof. And behind the pillar, there is a little more private area of the stage. That is called the rear stage. Rear stage. But rear stage was actually used to feature rooms like bedrooms and private rooms and libraries and study rooms, etc. in drama. For example, in the play Othello, Desdemona's bedroom was actually featured here in the rear stage. So it was a more private region. And then another example is in The Tempest, Prospero's den was featured there in the rear stage. So that's the rear of the stage. So it had a roof like structure. It was supported by two large Herculean pillars. So these pillars, in those times, these pillars were made of single huge tree trunks. Otta marathile aanu ee pillars kadanjeduthu vechittundayirunnathu. Appo angane aayirunnu idinte pratheegatha. And this roof, the roof above the pillars, it was actually called the heavens or the shadows. Heavens or shadows, angane aayirunnu adinte peer. Then another feature about Elizabethan stage is that, did you see any curtains in the stage? No. So there were no drop curtains in the Elizabethan stage. So that actually made the playwright work more, because at the end of every scene, the playwright had to provide some provision to indicate that the scene has come to an end. At the beginning of every scene, the playwright had to say that there is a change of scenery. So using the characters' dialogues, the playwright had to make provisions to indicate the end of a scene and the start of a new scene. Sometimes an end of a scene was marked by a rhyming couplet. ഒരു സീൻ എൻഡ് ചെയ്യുന്ന സമയത്ത് ഒരു ക്യാരക്ടർ സംസാരിക്കുമ്പോൾ രണ്ട് ലൈൻസിൽ എന്തെങ്കിലും ഒരു ഡയലോഗ് പറയും, ആ രണ്ട് ലൈനും റൈം ചെയ്യും. സച്ച് എ ലൈൻ വാസ് കോൾഡ് റൈമിംഗ് കപ്ലറ്റ്. So rhyming couplet was used to signify the end of a scene. And in some scenes there will be dead bodies on the stage, and these dead bodies, these corpses were carried out of the stage. There were provisions provided within the play. The play kathu enna parayunnundu oru scene end cheyumbodhekku ee mrudadeham namukku ivudunnu chumannondu pogam ennu characters thanne parayunnundu. Otherwise it would be really weird to see that in a scene a particular man died, and at the end of the scene, because there are no curtains, we can all the audience will be able to see the man getting up and walking away. So that will actually be very weird. So at the end of the scene where any dead bodies are there, there were provisions within the play itself to carry these corpses out of the stage. Then on the stage, they had multiple openings. Even in this picture, you can see that there are two doors on the side and there is a door in the middle too. So there were multiple openings on the stage. So the actors can go backstage to the tiring house, change costumes or anything they wanted. So this tiring house, this was the place where actors could change their costumes. And the musicians also sat there and played music for the play. And also within the tiring house, there was a set of stairs to access the upper layers, the upstairs rooms. So there were sets of stairs inside the tiring house. So then behind the apron stage, sometimes there would be curtains. Sometimes curtains were provided to give a little privacy. To indicate that it is a private room, like a bedroom or some such private setting. So sometimes curtains were provided behind the apron stage. It could be easily opened. It was not very thick curtain. It was actually sometimes transparent see-through curtains were used to look through them to see the rear stage. And then above the stage, this particular region is called the upper stage. Earlier we mentioned that this is the Lord's room, but in addition to being the Lord's room, this place was actually used in some scenes to indicate balcony scenes and all. For example, in Romeo and Juliet, they belong to two feuding families. The families are thick enemies with each other. But they meet and they fall in love with each other at the first sight. Now Romeo wants to go and see Juliet. Romeo goes to Juliet's house and Juliet is in her bedroom on the upstairs. And Romeo tries to get into her bedroom by climbing to the balcony. This particular exciting scene was actually featured here in this particular place. So this particular region was called, this particular spot was called the upper stage too. So the lords and ladies, the people who have purchased the most expensive seats, maybe they moved a little to the sides for such a play, such a scene to be staged. So that's the upper stage. And the most fashionable part of the theater was the stage itself. For example, if a person from the royal family or some patrons or some such important people came to the theater, they were provided seats on the stage itself. സ്റ്റേജിൻ്റെ ഒരു സൈഡിലായിട്ടൊക്കെ അവരെ ഇരുത്തി നാടകം കാണിക്കുമായിരുന്നു. അപ്പോൾ തിയേറ്ററിലെ എലിസബത്തൻ തിയേറ്ററിലെ ഏറ്റവും ശ്രേഷ്ഠമായിട്ടുള്ള ഭാഗം എന്ന് പറഞ്ഞാൽ സ്റ്റേജ് തന്നെ ആയിരുന്നു. സോ അനദർ ഫീച്ചർ ഓഫ് എലിസബത്തൻ തിയേറ്റർ ഇസ് ദാറ്റ് ദേ had no scenery. These theatres had no scenery. Scene paintings were not usually provided. So there also the playwright had the additional responsibility of describing each scene. At the start of the scene, some character would describe that they are in the field or they are near the river or they are near the sea. So through characters' dialogues, such descriptions about scenes had to be made because there were no set scenery in the theatre. So the location of the scenes, they relied on the dramatist including it within his character's dialogue. And sometimes to indicate that they are in a different country, it was communicated through the use of costumes, properties and music. So the players' costumes were also highly elaborate. And many movable objects like tables, thrones, chairs, beds, tents, armor, they were used in Elizabethan theatre. Another feature about Elizabethan theatre is that there was no artificial lighting. The only source of light in the theatre was the sun. So that meant that no play could be staged at night. So all kinds of performances should be done in the afternoon, commonly at 2 p.m. or 3 p.m. So that meant that Shakespeare, they had to, whenever there was a scene that was at night they had to make a character say that it is actually night. രാത്രിയാണെന്ന് ഡയലോഗിലൂടെ പറഞ്ഞു കൊടുക്കേണ്ട ഒരു ആവശ്യകതയുണ്ടായിരുന്നു. അത് പ്ലെയർ ആയിട്ട് ക്യാരക്ടേഴ്സിൻ്റെ ഡയലോഗിലൂടെ നമുക്ക് വ്യക്തമാക്കി തരുമായിരുന്നു. അനദർ ഡിവൈസ് വാസ് ദാറ്റ് ഇഫ് എ നൈറ്റ് ടൈം ഈസ് ബീയിങ് ഫിഗേർഡ്, വൺ ഓഫ് ദ ക്യാരക്ടേഴ്സ് വിൽ കം വിത്ത് എ കാൻഡിൽ ഓർ സംതിങ്. ഇറ്റ് വിൽ കമ്മ്യൂണിക്കേറ്റ് ദാറ്റ് ഇറ്റ് ഇസ് നൈറ്റ്. And then audience also, they had to suspend their disbelief for a while. They had to put logic aside and think that this is actually a scene which happens in the night. And another feature of Elizabethan theatre is that women were forbidden from working in the theatre. So all the female roles in Elizabethan stage was actually done by boys whose voices had not yet been broken. So in Shakespearean plays, we can actually see this element of disguise, particularly in comedies. That is because this women's costumes were too much to handle for these young boys. So they wanted some relief when they were on stage. So in most of the comedies, we can see that female characters at one point or another, they are disguising, passing off as boys within the play itself. So they are really young boys playing women, playing young boys. So that meant a lot of that resulted in a lot of confusion, sometimes confusion of identity and all. So actors, sometimes the actors played the same kind of character most of the time on Elizabethan stage too. And some kinds of props were used. We mentioned the use of tables, chairs, etc. And sometimes heavier properties like thrones were used, but heavier properties were just remained on the stage throughout. Lighter properties were carried away from the stage by servants. Then regarding theatres, the first theatre which was built in England was by James Burbage in a place called Shoreditch in the year 1576. This theatre was named the Theatre. So this was done in 1576. And in 1599, an important theatre was constructed. The name of the theatre was the Globe. This is the theatre where Shakespeare staged most of his plays. Other important theatres are the Curtain, the Rose, the Swan, the Fortune, etc. So these were important theatres during Elizabethan times. At this point of time, the city of London, within the city of London, going to the theatre was actually considered not a really good thing to do. So all these theatres were built outside the city, but not to in the rural villages, just outside the city in the suburban regions. For example, places like Southwark, that is where the Globe was located. So Shakespeare was first associated with the theatre and later he came in association with the Curtain and then the Globe. So that brings us to the end of this class on Elizabethan theatre and its structure. So we learned quite a few details in this class. We learned about the shape and the structure of Elizabethan theatre. We learned about the different seating arrangements like the pit, the gentleman's room, lord's room, tiring house, hut, etc. and three sets of galleries. We learned about the stage, apron stage, platform stage, rear stage, upper stage, etc. And we learned about the trapdoors on apron stage. We learned that there were no curtains in Elizabethan stage. There were multiple openings on the stage to go backstage. There were no drop curtains. We also learned that there was no scenery paintings. There was no artificial lighting. Women were forbidden from working in the theatre. Some props were used in the theatre. And we also learned about some important theatres in the Elizabethan times. So that brings us once again to the end of our class on Elizabethan theatre structure. Thank you for watching till the end. I hope this was beneficial for you. Let me know in comments. Thank you so much once again. Have a wonderful day. Bye.